to the SAP CADLink demo. My name is Amanda and I'm a project manager here at QBuild. QBuild has been doing PDM to ERP integration for over 10 years, and CADLink is a certified partner with SAP ERP. CADLink can integrate with more than 30 CAD, PDM, and PLM systems. This demo will show how to integrate bill of materials or BOM data from a SOLIDWORKS PDM data card to an SAP database. This tool will ultimately save time for manual data entry and eliminates potential BOM mistakes. To begin, you need to have the PDM File Explorer open as seen here. And let's say I am a designer or engineer and I have implemented some new changes to this assembly, such as created new items with new item codes, item name changes, quantity changes, and removed a few items. To ensure the SAP database has this updated bill of materials, I use CADLink to synchronize the data. With the PDM integration, CADLink is an add-in which can launch directly from the data card. So to run CADLink, I simply right-click on the assembly data card I wish to work on and select to run CADLink. First, I will be prompted to log into SAP and then choose which configuration I wish to work on. Once these initial prompts are dealt with, a splash screen will appear which is showing that the SAP and PDM systems are connecting, and the bill of material data in the PDM data card is being compared to the data currently in SAP. CADLink is looking at the item code, item name, and quantity. Once the comparison is complete, a grid-like user interface shows the comparison through highlighting. And CADLink also has the ability to show the user which part they are working on in the left-hand corner. Now moving on to the colored comparisons and starting with the white rows. So a white row indicates items that exist in both the PDM data card and the SAP database. This item was previously defined in the SAP item master, either through manual input or has already been pushed into SAP by CADLink. Next are the green rows. A green row indicates a new part, which does not exist within SAP database, however is present in the bill of material data card. When saved, CADLink will push the data present into the SAP bill of materials and item master. Next, we are going to look at the yellow highlights. A yellow highlight indicates a field level discrepancy. As an example, we will look at this item name. When comparing the item name, CADLink found that the PDM item name in the SAP database and the PDM data card did not match. The two item names can be seen simply by right-clicking, and the user can select between the two item names depending on which one is more correct or which one they would like to use. If neither is what they wish to use, they can always edit it themselves. When saved, CADLink will update the item name in the PDM data card and SAP item master. Lastly are the gray rows. A gray row is an item which exists in the SAP bill of materials, but is not present in the data card. This item would exist either due to engineering changes or it was removed from the model. When saved, the item highlighted in gray will be removed from the SAP bill of materials by CADLink so that the two bill of materials are back in sync. However, if you want to keep this item in the SAP bill of materials, you can unselect the saving column. And by doing this, when saved, CADLink will leave this part alone and will not create any changes. CADLink also has the ability to update the item group code, item property, and raw material information, as seen here on the right-hand side. Any previously existing data in the SAP database or PDM data card were populated when CADLink was launched. So a raw material can be added to an item simply by hovering over the material item code and selecting the box which appears. The user can then search for an item, either through the item code or item name, and accept that raw material. CADLink will populate the raw material information, as you can see here, for the user, which has been previously defined. CADLink also has additional tabs on the left-hand side, such as the BOM Changes tab, CAD Properties tab, and CADLink Messages tab. Starting with the BOM Changes tab, this is a read-only tab which lists the BOM changes created in this CAD link session. So for example, if a new item is added or deleted from the bill of materials, it will be listed here. Next are the CAD Properties tab. The CAD Properties tab is a read-only tab as well, which allows the user to view an item's PDM properties without the user having to close CAD link. Lastly is the CAD link messages tab. So the CAD link messages tab is a live data validation tab which lists the errors present in CAD link. CAD link will inhibit a user from saving the bill of material information if it contains errors or is incomplete. So as you can see here, currently the save option is grayed out, since there is an error existing in the data. To help the user find this error, they can simply right-click, and CAD link will bring the user to where that error exists. So I can just unselect my saving options, go back to my CAD link messages tab, and see that my error has been resolved. Once all the errors have been resolved, the save option will be enabled. Thank you for taking the time to watch this presentation. Hopefully, it has given you an idea of all the possible ways CAD link can save your team time and catch any errors.